spot your antenna nest and cut them from the air. So we managed to get some seed funding from the National Geographic Society and some other foundations, and happily went shopping with that small funding. At that point, we quickly discovered that commercially available drones are really expensive. They cost tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars. And we, like many of our fellow colleges, could not afford most of these systems. But perhaps more importantly, we realized that even if we had the money to purchase one of these equipment, we wouldn't have the funds to maintain it, especially in the kind of environment we were working in. So we, again, decided that we must look for a cheaper solution. Now, happily, we found that there is actually an amateur community of drone builders, a community of amateur drone builders that have contributed to a website, a forum called DIYdrones.com, which is started by Chris Anderson, CEO of GD Robotics. And using the information from their website, we managed to put together our prototype drone for just a few hundred dollars. And we brought that prototype to Indonesia in 2012 for its first field test. And it was a very exciting trip. We were there, we were not very sure what we were doing. We prepared the drone, planned our mission, flicked the switch, and tossed the drone in the air. Then we waited. 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes. And I turned to Serge and said that we must have screwed up. After all, this was just a foam plane and some electronics put together with some weird tape. But at around 20 minutes, we began to hear the familiar noise of the motor. And sure enough, we saw our drone flying back to us. Ecstatic, very happy about that. So we quickly landed the drone and looked through the footage. And we were blown away by what we saw. Now, sure enough, nowadays these kinds of footage are quite common, but at that time, that was the first time we saw the forest from the air. And even though we've been working in those forests for a good 10, 15 years in our career, we felt like there were birds soaring over our trees. It was fantastic. And we immediately saw the potential of this technology way beyond just our entire research. So when we came back to Europe, we told Brad Butler about our experience, and he was kind enough to write an article about it on conservation drones. And in fact, he was the one who coined the term